every action that we do is justified in our eyes. A pleasant and divine morning to you, my dear brothers and sisters. We have entered into the third day of the Lenten journey, a journey to go deep down in ourselves. The Word of God today invites us to know what type of fast the Lord requires from us. We read in the book of prophet Isaiah, chapter 58, verses 1 to 9. The Lord says, "Is such the fast that I choose? A day for a person to humble himself? Is it to bow down his head like a reed, and to spread sackcloth and ashes under him? Will you call this a fast and a day acceptable to the Lord?" In our own eyes, whatever we do, we feel it is justified and it is good. But the Lord today asks us, as we are in this Lenten observance and a journey of fast of 40 days, the Lord asks, the fast that you keep should change your heart. The fast that you keep should enable you to humble down yourself instead of making others to humble down before you. The Word of God again says, the Lord says, "Is it to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover him, and not to hide yourself from your own flesh." The Lord invites us today to do works of mercy. The fast that will enable us to humble down ourselves in the eyes of Lord. Dear friends, the more we humble ourselves, God will raise us up. This Lenten season should help us to become aware of the fast that we keep. Usually, we fast and we pray, but sometimes that prayer is not heard, and then there is a question in our mind, "Oh God, why my prayer is not heard?" But the Lord, who sees the heart, He tells, check your attitude. With what intention you keep the fast? Is it to slim your body, or is it to have a change in your heart? Dear friends, as we enter into this third day of this Lenten observance, let us ask the Lord to give us the grace. As the Word of God says in 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 9, St. Paul says, "My grace is sufficient for you, for the power is made perfect in your weakness." We are weak in ourselves, but the Lord, who is great, is always with us. The Gospel speaks to us today from Matthew chapter 9, 14 to 15, saying that, "Can the wedding guest mourn as long as the bridegroom is with them?" Again, we hear in the Word of God that Jesus says, "I am with you till the end of the age." As long as Jesus is with us, as long as our God is with us, we should not be afraid of our own weaknesses. Rather, the moments of our falling down, the moments of our temptations, the moments of our wickedness may enable us to humble down ourselves before God, so that He may bless us with His Spirit and enable us to have the true spirit of fasting that would change our life, change our emotions, change our feelings, and may enable us to become a grace, a blessing, and a new changed person, so that whosoever comes in our contact of our life may experience the grace of God flowing from us, asking the Lord to forgive us all our sins that knowingly or unknowingly we have done. The Lord, who is merciful, will show His mercy upon us. Let us ask the Lord to forgive our sins as we say,
Mercy Lord, we have sinned, listen to our plea. Mercy Lord, we have sinned, answer now our prayer. Mercy Lord, we have sinned, listen to our plea. Mercy Lord, we have sinned, answer now our prayer. We have turned from the poor, let the hungry die. We neglect the oppressed, we ignore their cry. Now's the time, now's the day, turn back to your God. Turn your hearts, cry to Him, spare your people, Lord. Mercy, Lord, we have sinned, listen to our plea.
May the Lord, who blesses us at every moment to have a change in our heart, may bless us all. Thank you and have a graceful day.